Because, I mean, there's a couple of ways that you can play this. You can fully commit to the defensive game and try to break Potemkin's armor and utilize, like, the multi-hit moves that you have in, like, your 5 heavy slash and things like that. Or you could go on the offensive and abuse the fact that Potemkin is kind of tall and go for some more complex mix-ups and keep him really under pressure with, like, the overheads and everything. So I'll be interested to see Mocha's approach and Noah's approach as well as you hop in here game one. Yeah, we see that armor already coming into play. One hit of armor there, so was able to get through Jacko, but was not able to make contact. Hammerfall is punishable, though, so that's going to be useful information for Noah. Not getting punished off the first Hammerfall on block means that that's a neutral tool that you have access to with, like, minimal risk, you know? There's a free way in. Okay. Yeah, there it is. Yeah, you're going to see a lot more of those hammer falls time and time again. But what I did not expect was the super reversal. Yeah, you know what? I don't want to block Garuda Impact either. I don't blame you, Mocha. Nice confirm here off the minions. Noah attempting to fight back here. Oh my god, yeah, hammer fall goes for the anti-air there. Mocha did not commit to a button. That was a smart choice. Yo, nice flick. Quarter positioning. This is rough here for Mocha all of a sudden. Son, what an RC cancel. Beautiful reaction there from Noah, able to get their first round. It was looking a little bit bleak, but just made the right decision there to get in. Yeah, there. Oh my god. Okay, so actually, interestingly enough, that was not a punish. It was a counter hit. So Noah possibly still not deterred from doing a hammerfall on block. Yo, the burst. So Noah committed to the burst, I think, just to kind of get Mocha off of them. Completely whiffed, so did not really get any advantage for that at all whatsoever. Oh my god, we do the armored minions? I love this. This is a kind of underrated tool in Jacko's kit, in my opinion. The armored minions, you can't get rid of them. So yeah, just like that, Noah hit a button and just made contact with basically nothing. Got punished for, like, I don't know, 20% for trying to hit. Like, that super's ridiculous. All right, the hammerfall coming in clutch yet again. Yo, what? Yo, that was vacuum hands right there, all right? Jacko was nowhere near that fist and just simply magnetized herself over to Potemkin's knuckles over there. But yeah, Mocha tying up 1-1 in rounds. What do we got here? Okay, oh my god, yeah, off the knockdown. Mocha already feeling the pressure. Bursting. But turning the tides here off the throw, trying to get some minion sets up. What? Son, I ask again. The hitbox is nowhere near Jacko. It's literally a vacuum. Just being sucked into the command throw, or the attack throw, whatever you want to call it. Oh snap, is that going to whip punish? If that was going to whip punish, that would have been the greatest whip punish I've ever seen. Okay, Noah with the lockdown here. Yeah, Mocha locked in his corner. Not going to be deterred from pressing buttons because of it though. Fights her way out with a far slash, but just cut. Seem to be having trouble getting anything of their game plan started. Going to be trying the armored minions yet again. That did see success last time. You see all the minions on the screen here, Noah just forced them back up. You know, that oppressive approach that they had completely kind of deterred by the minion play here by Mocha. But much to their demise, unfortunately, Noah gonna be able to poke out and find their first game. A close one though. It really felt like it was back and forth. I loved Mocha's decision to commit to those minion play, because that seemed to be what was kind of deterring Noah previously. Oh man, we need a punish there. Yeah, if Mocha can't find a way to punish Hammerfall on block, it's really going to make this matchup 10 times harder. Because, like, it's a free way in. Or, like, we've noticed that Mocha's kind of presence at this matchup is when they're able to get the minions out, keeping Potemkin at bay and being able to play their game. But if Noah finds that they're able to just hammer break through that for free on block, full screen, and not get punished, it's going to make it really hard here for Mocha. Oh, my God. Yeah, all the buttons in the world. Potemkin looking like a sword character right now. Oh my god, setting up the shield in front. Oh, just walks! Dude, you know what? I've been there. This big-bodied grappler robot-looking unit over here just throws a Aegis Reflector at your face, and you just panic. What do? Just run straight into it. I've been there. Oh my god, yeah, yet another one. Wow, it got completely nullified. That was a crazy interaction. I was not expecting that. Burst available here for Noah, but if it's going to be used, it's maybe going to be used as a gold burst or anything. I mean, they have such a huge life lead, such huge advantage here up against Mocha. Oh my gosh, yeah, the button's out of control again, I say. Potemkin looking like a sword character here with the way that Noah's just kind of like controlling the neutral in the mid-range game. Jacko has not really gotten much presence or opportunity to play, and I think Mocha recognizes they're going to be going for a character swap. Over to the other Valentine sister, not feeling the Jacko, going over with the Ramathal, okay? Yeah, so it looks like they have the same character spread and ideology as a Dadpool. Just simply play the Valentine sisters. Yeah, I mean, historically, over the patches of this game, Ramlethal Pot, I'm not going to say that it's been, like, fully Ramlethal favorite, but I mean, if, based on the way Noah is playing, if you're looking to play those mid-range games a bit better with access to, like, longer reaching buttons and, like, make Noah think twice about hitting them, this will definitely be to Mocha's advantage. Now, the issue is, previously with Jackal, just embedded with her kit on, like, her far heavy slash because it's multi-hit, some of the other multi-hit buttons that she has, she can naturally beat Hammer Break. Ramlethal doesn't really have that. All of Ramlethal's stuff is like, although it's oppressive and like mid-range, it's all single hit. So you're not gonna be able to like luckily just like get through like a Hammerfall or anything. So Mocha is still gonna be pressured to find a punish for that move when it happens. But right now, really kind of controlling the neutral game, already has Noah cornered and looking to keep that corner as they use that burst early. Oh my god, yeah, the new Rekka for Ramlethal is absolutely insane. I don't know why she has it. Alright, full dust confirm. Are you kidding me? Backwards Mega Fist hit cross up off the run under. That's illegal. Mega Fist. Mega Fist? Yo, give me another Mega Fist. Not quite. Thinking about it though. Oh my god, knocked down. You gotta guess. Nice jump out. Just no, you need a punish there. Yeah, jumped out of the Potemkin Buster, but the threat of it, just too much in order to catch in a punish. Mocha in trouble here. Mega Fist hell. And a Hammer Break, I'm telling you. License to Hammer Break is a license to kill for Potemkin players, as Noah's gonna be one round away from being able to take this match. It's looking really oppressive here in the neutral game. Again, Mega Fist after Mega Fist. It could be a hard special to interact with, no matter who you are. Wow, I love that 2P there to stop the Ramlethal approach. That was very good there from Noah. Yeah, having full, it's so crazy how in playing Potemkin, how much control of the neutral game they have had against the character spreads that they played against. You know, Jacko and Ramlethal, definitely two characters that are quite impressive in the mid-range neutral game, and Noah's just been playing around it so effortlessly. Hammer Break, no, still no punish. That's, yeah, not great there for Mocha, but still able to find some hits. Loving that jump over. Okay, Mocha, starting to heat up a little bit here. Corner positioning, what do we have here? Yikes, that was very smart. I like that. Yeah, just instantly go into the super for the wall break, lock out any burst, able to get a burst of their own with punish on the Garuda, and the sword throw is going to be able to get around here for Mocha. I'm loving it. Signs of life, signs of life. Mocha not out of this yet. That was a very strong round. I liked a lot of their decision making there. Burst instantaneously. Don't let Noah get started. Please punish. Okay, it's something. It's something. It's a jab. We're learning. Okay. Yeah, Mocha needs to be careful. Just getting that heavy slash sword back. Has been throwing that a lot in the neutral game to keep Noah at bay. The only issue with that, as you do that, you lose access to your longer range normals. But yeah, in this case, where you're closer to the corner, easy money. Just go ahead and pick it right back up. Keep your pressure going. But Noah having none of that. Just going to Mega Fist their way out of the corner by any means necessary. Build up that risk gauge in the process. Mocha in a bit of trouble. Love that. We'll put us on the flip from literally full screen. Dash cut. Do it. Oh, never mind. No, you don't have that sword. Whips on the heavy sword toss. Did that. Stun. That crosses up. That's illegal. Okay. Oh my god, this can go either way right here. Neither player has a burst. Both of them just playing that mid-range game that's been working out for both of them thus far. Oh my god. Oh, beautiful jump over there from Mocha to get over the Aegis Reflector. Stuck in the corner. Oh, I think they were expecting a pot buster, and Noah expected Mocha expecting a pot buster and just...